Without Jesus, without sins rather, Jesus died for nothing. How does the Catholic Church, as the Western authority on religious morality, encourage the veneration of saints, who those who are canonized in the understanding that can mediate between the Lord and normal people? In my research, I have considered the idea Zizek conveyed on faith, in that its power lies in our inability to understand God's plan, and thus we turn to these figureheads of morality in order to guide us towards a better understanding. The Church is built on the acceptance of our own ignorance. Only then may we accept it as law. But Kahn suggested God is dead, but doesn't know it. We apparently have an innate need to worship, and we have to have a cultural moral structure. The need for a comforting oppressor becomes instinct. I hope to continue to explore our need to model ourselves on this structure. My current practice deals with the concept of sinner and saint, and how they intertwine and contrast through the medium of video installation. My initial experience with experimenting with film occurred last year, where I discussed the position of the white male in society using a floating head on a black screen. This was inspired partially by Samuel Beckett's Not I, which focuses on the mouth alone and thus the dialogue and a sense of eyes being explored. I was interested in this element of confrontation that focusing on the face provides. This didacticism followed me into the third year, and I did enjoy this awful, I know, second year stuff, you know, I like to think I've improved slightly. Anyway, so before this, however, after this rather, we were to create short pieces over the summer, and I wish to finally focus on a bit of digital art. So what happens when you press the devil's doorbell is a piece that is based on female masturbation, so I was exploring morality, and I wanted to look at what I could do with the layers in Photoshop, and this is sped up to 1,000%, so it'd be a lot slower and a lot more subtle. But you know, digital art builds on the limitations of what a canvas brings. You know, you're allowed to do a lot more with it. So anyway, moving on to autumn term, I collaborated with Sarah Pritchard, and we looked at a piece which explores ultimate productivity. The final product consisted of performance, installation and video, all of which were used to create a convenient environment where we could undertake as many tasks as possible within an allotted amount of time. Was ultimate productivity really that productive? Not really, because all we got out of it was a sandy room and lines and walls which took us about a term to paint off. Though I did not continue this theme, it was a great opportunity to improve my skills in film editing and to use the green screen, and also to look into video installation and how I use the gallery space. The end of the video launched me into my current interest, the Catholic faith. As it was pointed out, the prayer section of the video was distinctly Christian, and that made me think about the cross as a simulacrum and how the iconography of the church perpetuates our very culture. I began with a digital illustration of St. Cecilia, taking an interest in the iconography of religious art during the Renaissance at the height of the Holy Roman Empire. I wanted to take into account what makes someone a saint, what does it mean to be sinful or morally righteous, and why is being a virgin a virtue? Why does martyrdom give you a better chance of being a saint than simply living a good life when it comes dangerously close to, let's be honest, suicide? And why do we accept such gruesome imagery only in the context of the church? Which brings me to The Exorcist of St. Teresa by Bellini, which depicts the saint's religious experience. But I thought it was quite erotic, her facial expression, and lo and behold, Mathilde wrote a book where her face was used on the cover, so it wasn't just my dirty mind. So after this, it brought me to looking at Julian Wearing's Confessional video, and brought me back to the confrontational element of the face once again. A number of participants confessed in various levels of disguise. And then after that, I looked at Samuel Beckett's play, which again focuses on the face. And I combined that with Fellini's Roma, which satirises the Catholic Church in a borderline sacrilegious way. So from this, I created Catholic Guilt, There is a Sin for Everything These Days, which consists of actors made to look like a particular saint through Photoshop, reading out confessions of sins which oppose the virtue of that particular saint. Confession, is a key part of the Catholic Church and a person's right to path to righteousness. So I thought it was important to explore. The piece was projected onto a cabinet which contained wine and communion wafers to represent a Eucharistic tabernacle. The piece is under development as I decided to use headphones later on so you can actually hear the sound because the voices are the most sacrilegious element of the piece. In addition to this, I've also been experimenting with aspects of Photoshop inspired by Pierre et Lille's pop culture inspired pieces, which has brought me on to kind of experimenting through a bit of humour. But then later on, I approach this kind of more, I find, aesthetically pleasing style. But at the same time, I'm kind of looking at that almost magazine-esque, oh, she's a virgin, we can't quite touch her, you know, look how amazing they are sort of style. I've created prayer cards with these, which I've handed out, so you can have a look at them. And I wish to continue exploring the style alongside the more crudely illustrated style of my video. I hope to continue exploring the simulacrum of the cross, how faith works, and perhaps pushing the boundaries of what is considered overtly sacrilegious and offensive. And I may even explore, as I continue on, hell and what punishment awaits us. Thank you, clergy. Questions?
Very good. Any questions?
Did you self-time the PowerPoint?
Did I self-time it?
Yeah.
Yeah, I did. It wasn't a PowerPoint, so it's a video, which is why I probably spoke a bit quickly, because I was like, I've got to fit this in and time it just about exactly, so excuse my fast in the room.